Hello children, this was 7th standard science, unit 5 in biology, basis of classification. It's in your book, page number 70. Now let us start our lesson. First we will see what are the learning objectives. To understand the need for dichotomous classification, to classify animals according to their characteristic features, to know the classification of animals and get the knowledge about invertebrates and vertebrates, to acquire knowledge about the classification of plants, to know the importance of five kingdom classification, finally to understand the binomial nomenclature. So in this lesson we are going to see about the plants and animals, how they are classified, how they are grouped. Okay children, next first we'll see the introduction part. So in the introduction part, what they have informed means, so here you know there are two things, living things and non-living things, isn't it? Living things, there are specific characteristics, that is they can breathe, they can move, they can grow. Non-living things cannot move, cannot grow. Yes, it will be in a particular place itself. It cannot breathe. Isn't it? So, the things which are present on the earth are classified into two things, living things and non-living things. Again, if you take non-living things, it can be classified. Isn't it? Yes, wooden materials, plastic materials, iron materials, glass materials like that. Again, it may be classified. Isn't it? So, this only explained in this introduction part. You can see the things in the classroom, how they are classified. In the classroom, the things which are present are classified into two things, wooden materials and non-wooden materials. And if you take wooden materials, again it is writing materials, sitting materials. Writing materials, you can say fixed and portable. Portable means it can move. So fixed blackboard with a wooden frame and portable pencil, wooden scale, color pencil, eraser, book and notebook. Like that, sitting materials with arm, without arm. With arm means chair, without arm means table. Like that, non-wooden materials, again it is classified into writing materials and sitting materials. Writing materials, fixed and portable, blackboard, whiteboard and all, and portable pens, ruler, color pencil, pencil box, chalk pieces. Then again, sitting materials with arm, without arm, chair that is iron or plastic, without arm, table or plastic. So if you classify the things like this, you can understand easily. Suppose you, if you are going to library, yes, you want to get some book. Suppose I am giving one activity in science and you have to pick that book, means how will you pick? Only if the books are arranged in a proper manner, yes, you can select it. Tamil book separately, English book, maths book, science book, social science book, again Tamil book, Tamil novels, stories, yes, and also poems. Like that, if it is arranged in a proper manner, you can take the book easily. Isn't it, children? Like that, if you, in your home, yes, you are having your books, yes, books and notebooks, guides, writing materials, table, chair, everything. If you are arranging it in a proper manner, you can take it easily. Isn't it? So, everything comes under classification. So, this classification, how they are classified means, there should be some similarities and differences exist among materials. Yes, based on some similarities and differences exist among these materials, we are classifying. Isn't it? Yes, so now we will see what is dichotomous key. Dichotomous key allow us to make quick reference and identify a particular thing. Dichotomous key allow us to make quick reference and identify a particular thing. So classification provides
scientist, a systematic, easy way of studying organisms. So classification is done using the dichotomous key. So what is dichotomous key? It is a tool used to classify organisms based on their similarities and differences. So based on the similarities and differences, the living organisms are classified. So this classification we call that as dichotomous key. So what are the features of dichotomous key? A single feature that differentiate a group easily. One character selected to separate the group as present or absent. So continue the second step until only one item will remain at the end. So this you can, I will explain with this example itself. So here non-wooden materials classified into writing material and sitting material based on the usage, isn't it? So this writing materials are used for writing, sitting materials are used for sitting. Again, writing materials, it is divided into two things, fixed and portable. Fixed means it cannot move, portable means it can move. Isn't it, children? And again, the examples are given. Like this we call it as dichotomous key. So a single feature that differentiate a group easily, one character selected to separate the group as present or absent, and continue the second step. This will continue till you get only one. So we call that as dichotomous key. So how we look? A dichotomy of animals we'll see now. Using the dichotomy pattern, classify the given list of animals. Now they are giving some example of many animals and they are asking you to classify it. How will you classify? Ostrich, peacock, monkey, frog, toad, turtle, snake, shark, goldfish, and tapeworm, earthworm, and leech. So on seeing this animal picture, you can find out some similarities and differences. For example, presence or absence of backbone, we can classify into two groups, isn't it? Presence of backbone, absence of backbone. Other thing, animals with backbone can be divided easily into subgroup based on its body temperature. And further classification can be done based on its difference, like presence of feather, absence of feather, presence of hair, scales like that. Okay, so first on seeing the animal itself, we are dividing it into two categories, the presence of backbone and absence of backbone. So basics of classification. So living organisms are so large in number that they need to be classified into smaller groups. Then only we can identify and we can understand the features of plants and animals. So classification of living organisms is made on the basis of their characteristics, that is similarities and differences. So here how the animals are classified. So the animals are classified. First, living things are classified into plants and animals. Okay, now we'll see animals first. Classification of animals, it is classified into vertebrates and invertebrates. So vertebrates means the animals which are having backbone. We call them as vertebrates. The animals which are not having backbone, we call that as invertebrates. Clear, children? The next step. Again, the invertebrates, it is classified into two things, warm-blooded and cold-blooded. Yes, so based on the temperature, based on the temperature of the body, again it is classified into warm-blooded and cold-blooded. Clear, children? The next thing, again warm-blooded animals, it is classified, warm-blooded animals, again it is classified into mammals and birds. Mammals means the animals which will give birth to younger ones and they will feed milk. So we call that animals as mammals. You know that one. So warm-blooded animals, again it is classified into mammals and birds. And cold-blooded animals, again it is classified into fish, reptiles and amphibians. Amphibians means the animals which can live both in water and also on land. Yes, children. So invertebrates, again it is classified into with jointed legs and without legs. With jointed legs and without legs. Again, with jointed legs, it is classified into two categories, with three pair of legs, with more than three pair of legs. Okay, children, and without legs, it is like worm-like or not worm-like. Like this, this classification will be going on till you reach a single item. Till you reach single item. So that we call it as classification. Clear, children? So Aristotle was a great philosopher and thinker who lived about 2400 years ago. So Aristotle came up with the following grouping system that was used for almost 2000 years after his death. So Aristotle, he classified the things into main categories, two categories, and people followed that method. He classified all organisms into animals or plants. Again, he classified into with blood, without blood. And then the animals were classified into three groups based on their method of movement: walkers, flyers, or swimmers. So here one activity is given, that is color buttons are given. Yes. So I am asking you to group the buttons. So first, what will you do? First, you will select the colors. Is based, the colors are very attractive. So first, based on the colors you can segregate, or based on the holes present you can segregate, or based on the size you can segregate. Isn't it, children? So we call this as the classification. So the method of arranging the organisms into groups, the method of arranging the organisms into groups is called classification. So when we classify things, we put them into groups based on their characteristics. So why do we classify things? So classifying things makes it easy for us to know the similarities and differences. So based on the similarities and differences, if you classify the things, it will be easy for you to identify and also know about the things. Second one, things with similar characters are classified into same group. So these group things are usually similar in at least one characteristic. Then things with different characteristics are classified into different groups, and these groups are usually different in at least one characteristic. So based on the similarities also you can group, or based on the difference also you can group it. So classification help us to understand living and non-living things in better way. So for example, we can classify a newly discovered organisms, we would come to know how it relates with other. So what, why it is needed? Why classification is needed? Classification is needed to identify an organism correctly. It helps to know the origin and evolution of an organism. So evolution means how that organisms came into existence. Now for example, first we got COVID-19, yes, coronavirus. Now we have many countries, they have reached the second type of virus, yes, stimulated virus, like that. So the origin and evolution of organism, and to establish the relationship among different organisms. It provides the information about the living things in different geographical regions, and also it helps in understanding how complex organisms must have evolved from simpler ones. So scientists have been able to discover and classify more than 2 million organisms are present on the earth. Yes, so based on the size and structure, based on the movement, based on the food what they are taking, like that we have to classify. Yes, so based on the food we can take, so the animals are classified into herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. That you know, herbivorous means the animals will eat only the plants, carnivorous means only the meat, and omnivorous means both. Isn't it, children? Like that, if you classify the things, you can understand it in a clear manner. Okay, children. So here 2 million organisms on the earth, ranging from tiny bacteria to the largest blue whales. So each organism has been classified in a category based on its evolutionary relationship with the other group of organisms. So we can define hierarchy of organisms as the system of arranging the system of arrange, it is a two important 2-mark question. The system of arranging taxonomic categories in a descending order based on their relationships with the other group of organisms is called hierarchy of categories. So this system was introduced by Linnaeus and is called Linnaean hierarchy. So there are 7 main categories of hierarchies, namely kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So in your portion you are going to see only phylum and class. Okay, kingdom, phylum and class. So species is the basic unit of classification. So based on the above classification, the following table shows different phylum with the general characteristics and examples of different phyla and classes. So here if you see this table, it is giving out the general characteristics and also what division it is coming under. So first nine phylum, it comes under the animals which are not having backbone. That is first 9 phylum are invertebrates and the next 5 classes are vertebrates. Okay children, so first we will see each and everything, every phylum, they have given one example and also the general characters. So first I will see phylum Protozoa. Example for phylum Protozoa is Amoeba, Euglena and Paramecium. So what are the general characteristics? It is microscopic. There are 2 types of animals there, microscopic, macroscopic. Microscopic organism means you can observe that organisms only through the microscope. Macroscopic means you can see the organisms with the naked eye. The next one, unicellular. Based on the cells present in an organism, we can say if the organism is having only one cell, we call that as unicellular. Multicellular means more cells. Clear children? But here amoeba is having only one cell. Okay, so we call that as unicellular. Then pseudopodia. Pseudopodia means the organ which is used for moving. Okay, pseudopodia. Flagella. Flagella means hair-like substance. Cilia is also hair-like structure which is used for locomotion. Locomotion means moving from one place to another place. And also reproduction. Reproduce by fission and conjugation. So, and each and every characteristic table, if you observe, it is telling about whether it is microscopic or macroscopic, unicellular or multicellular, whether how it is moving from one place to another place, and also how it is reproducing. Okay, all these characters are explained. The next one, phylum Porifera. Example, Spongilla, Cycan. So if you see this characters, it is multicellular organisms with the holes in the body and skeleton formed of spicules, asexual, and it is reproduced by sexual and asexual. And next one, phylum Coelenterata. It is also multicellular organisms, diploblastic, sessile or free swimming, solitary. Solitary means individually it will present, or colonial. Colonial means it can be present as a group. And asexual, the reproduction is by asexual or and sexual reproduction. Then next one, phylum Platyhelminthes. Example, liver fluke, blood fluke, tapeworm, acelomates. Parasites. Parasites means it cannot produce its food. It will depend on other organisms for getting food. So parasites inside the body of animals and human beings, mostly hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means bisexual. Both the sex organs will be present in it. Okay children, the next one, unsegmented body, mostly parasites in human beings and animals, causing diseases, and also it will reproduce by asexually reproduction. Example, that is phylum Ascalminthes. Example, Ascaris lumbricoides. The next one, phylum Annelida. Triploblastic, it is also segmented body, mostly hermaphrodite, that is bisexual and unisexual. Okay, mostly bisexual and sometimes it is unisexual. The next one, phylum Arthropoda. Example, crab, prawn, millipede, insect, scorpion and spider. It is having segmented body,
thick cutaneous cuticle forming an exoskeleton, that is on the outer part of, that is like the skin will be very shiny appearance. Yes, cuticle will be present. Pad and jointed legs, unisexual, exhibits sexual dimorphism. Then phylum Mollusca, example cuttlefish, snail, octopus. It is soft bodied, unsegmented, muscular head, foot and visceral mass, mantle and calcareous shell, and sexual reproduction. So if the question is asked, you can write the phylum name and example, any two example, general characters also you can write any two, that is enough. Yes, phylum Echinodermata, starfish, sea fish, and then brittle star, etc. It is exclusively marine. Marine means it will be living only in the water. Marine. Spines and spicules all over the body. That is spicules means one type of that is like a horn. Mullu madri irukum. Yes, spicules over the body. Water, vascular system. Tube feet for feeding, respiration and locomotion and sexual reproduction. So all this nine phylum are invertebrates. Okay children, the next one we'll see vertebrate, that is phylum Chordates. It is classified into five classes. First class Pisces, that is shark, Cattla, mullet and tilapia. That is aquatic. Aquatic means it will be living in water. Cold-blooded vertebrates with boat-shaped body and jaws. Locomotion. Locomotion means movement by pad and median fins, and it will do sexual reproduction. Then class amphibian, example frog. Amphibians, cold-blooded, two pairs of limbs, and it undergo sexual reproduction. Class reptilia, garden lizard, house lizard. Is cold-blooded, the characters are cold-blooded, lung breathing, it is having lung for breathing, scales over the body, all over the body it will have that horn-like structure, scales, and pentadactyl limb, adapted for climbing, running and padding, oviparous. The next one, class Ace, water bird, roller bird, it is warm-blooded, exoskeleton of feathers, it is having feathers, flight or for flying, flight adaptation, spongy bones with air cavities. So only its body is very light and it can fly. Yes, then powerful eyes, and it undergoes sexual reproduction, oviparous. Then next one, class Mammalia, duckbill, platypus, kangaroo. So terrestrial, warm-blooded, external ear or pinna, muscular diaphragm, non-nucleated RBC, heterodont and diphyodont dentition, viviparous, give birth to younger ones. So this invertebrates are classified into 9 phylum, and 10th phylum Chordates, it is classified into 5 classes, that all these 5 classes having backbone, so we call that as vertebrates. Okay children, so here the picture is given and you can fill in, that is they have asked vertebrates, invertebrates, vertebrate with wings, so you can write the examples there. The next one, the picture is given, picture wise picture study is given, so you can see each and every classification: mammal, sponge, jellyfish, worm, mollusca, echinodermata, arthropoda, Pisces, amphibians, reptiles, apes. So by seeing this picture you can understand what are all the examples for this classification, animal classification. Okay children, I hope you understand this. So I'll stop with this. In the next class we'll see about plant classification. Okay children, so up to this what are all the things we have seen, let us see once again. Yes, the first point, classification of living organisms is made on the basis of their characteristics, similarities and differences. Yes, second one, classification is needful to identify living organisms and to study about them conveniently. Then third point, kingdom is the largest division of the living world, and species is the basic unit of classification. So kingdom Animalia is divided into two subkingdoms, invertebrates and vertebrates. So the living things, it is classified into two kingdom, plants and animals, and animal kingdom, it is classified into invertebrates, that is animals without backbone, vertebrates, animals with backbone. The next one, invertebrates are classified into
9 phyla, and vertebrates are classified into 5 classes. Okay children, so with this I'll stop this lesson. Let us continue the classification of plants in next class. Thank you children.